And
5 seconds remaining.
We are live. Game 3, Fireman versus Nigma. Banning phase opens up with classic bans Io and Phoenix. Although on the other side, Nigma doesn't want to play against Doom and Magnus. And look at these very quick drafts. Tiny was not banned and immediately gets picked. Then on the other side, Vengeful Spirit for Nigma. That's very interesting choice for a support hero.
5 seconds remaining.
Let's see what is the next pick here. For the five men, they might wanna go for some standard picks here. Let's see if there'll be any Rubik or anything else. He's highly valued in this tournament, I believe. We've seen a lot of good plays, especially from I believe it was yesterday in the game.
Dire team pick.
EG had a lot of success on it. Although, look at this. Radiant Nature's Prophet and Batrider on the other side. This could be mid or offlane Batrider, most likely offlane. Nature's Prophet, maybe mid, I'm not sure. I did not see the draft for game number one. I think it was mid Nature's Prophet that time. Although they might do something different here. Let's wait and see. Another ban from five men is Arc Warden. Last game did not go very well for them. Miracle was able to play and do really well on Arc Warden, and they also banned Anti-Mage. So those are two denied picks for him. On the side of Nigma, Darkseer banned. Let's see, what else do they want to ban? What are the heroes? Okay, Spectre banned. That's interesting. So they don't want to get chased on the map at all. They don't want to deal with the Surge heroes. They don't want to deal with Spectre. It is very likely they will go for a lot of single target spells and
5 heroes. 5 seconds remaining.
And just burst everybody. They would probably go for Boots of Travel, Blink, Batrider, maybe Foreign Staff.
Dire team banned.
Terrorblade banned. Okay. Let's see, what does Nigma want to ban? They are playing against Tiny Nature's Prophet. What else can be good with those
10 heroes? 10 seconds remaining.
I'm dire not sure.
Team pick.
Wow,
Radiant
that's a good ban.
Rubik.
Okay, there's the Rubik. Pretty good all-round support pick here. So we are definitely gonna see Rubik and Vengeful Spirit supports, and Batrider is most likely offlane here.
Remaining.
And on the side of five men, well, next
five
pick is gonna reveal a lot. Is it gonna be another support? They did use a lot of their reserve time here. Let's see. What do they want to pick?
Dire team pick.
Puck.
Puck. This is most likely a support Puck. I'm not sure. I don't think they would pick their mid hero so early in the
10 seconds remaining.
Draft.
5 seconds remaining. Radiant team pick.
Medusa.
Very interesting draft. Medusa. So this is safe lane Medusa. And then what's left for them? In the mid lane they might go for Dragonite.
I think they
would like to pick something that's a little bit more tanky. Magnus was banned.
Remaining.
They need a good frontliner, I believe. What are the other options? Maybe they could go even for Windranger or Cheese, pick their Meepo, which is Weeha's hero, or maybe just go for a safe draft and pick Windranger mid. Although they did play it, I believe, offlane in one of their previous games. So maybe that could work. Offlane Windranger, mid Batrider, and safe lane Medusa. But on the side of Flyman, let's see, what do they want to pick
Radiant
next?
Team Baron.
Okay, that should be safe lane Troll.
Dire team ban.
And they ban Pugna, so they definitely don't want a mid Pugna. Oracle ban from Nygma. Okay. So what does that leave then? They maybe wanted to prevent Oracle plays
10 seconds
with the
remaining.
Tiny, with Puck, with Troll especially. They don't
Five
want that Troll to stand
remaining.
And fight and get the extra heal and prevent prevention
Dire team
from death.
Ban.
Okay, Beastmaster banned. And now Nygma's turn. What do they want to ban here? Clockwork? Is he a good choice here?
10 seconds remaining! 5 seconds remaining!
Let's see. I mean, Medusa doesn't do well with very mobile heroes and some good ranged harassers. Also, the few defusal carriers. I don't know what they want to pick or ban here against.
Radiant team pick.
Wow, Queen of Pain. So they are expecting a mid draft from the side of five men. This Puck is most definitely a support. He will support the Troll Warlord, I believe,
remaining.
And then Tiny and Nature's Prophet offlane. And that
five
leaves mid
seconds
only.
Remaining.
What do they want to play here? They might want to go for a very mobile hero
Dire
again.
Team pick.
Venomancer.
No, Venomancer. So is this Nature Prophet to play mid and Venomancer offlane? Although anything is open up.
10 seconds remaining.
Anything is open now in this type of draft. Let's see.
5 seconds remaining.
Nygma will pick what? Dragonite?
Choose your hero!
Underlord. Okay, that's interesting. So, offlane Batrider, safe lane Medusa, and. No, mid Batrider. Yeah, mid Batrider, and then there is safe lane Medusa and off lane Underlord. Okay, I'm not very familiar with the laning of five men. I haven't watched any of their games, unfortunately. I don't know if Pylite Dies is mid. I think he is.
Now for the old razzle dazzle.
10 seconds remaining.
Well, I apologize for my lack of knowledge here. Remaining.
Now for the old razzle dazzle. Now for the old razzle dazzle.
I am slightly more familiar with Nygma, so that their draft is pretty clear here. Okay, that's the drafting stage done. Now let's wait for the game to start. I just want to check. Okay, yeah, there is no other games being played. Okay, we are still waiting for the game to start. There it is. There's a little bit of a pause there, and let's see, any items bought. There's the Weeha on his typical opening build with the observer ward that will end up placed here. Let's see, is this Venomancer mid? Nature's Prophet has Blightstone, so he will be offlane, safe lane troll, and let's see who's playing the mid buck. I am curious about the Venomancer's build. He does have Quelling Blade, he has two Fairy Fires. I don't know what does he want to do. Look at Puck, that's a very offensive ward, slightly. He will want to see the rotations coming this side. And a little bit of vision next to the top rune. There's the standard ward there. Mind Control, Handstick, Quelling Blade. Okay, there's the Puck mid. He also has Magic Stick. That's
30 seconds to battle.
Mandatory against the Batrider. Now let's see what's gonna happen here. They want to walk in with Tiny and Nature Prophet. Nature's Prophet.
Saving your will to live.
Top Miracle, there he is. Vengeful Spirit, that's a standard lane. Yeah, I think Venomancer and Puck will be off lane. So does that make Nature's Prophet support? No. A lot of harassment on the Rubick, and Tiny is the support, and Venomancer is position 3. Okay, so those are the lanes, which leaves the Nature's Prophet as a safe lane support. Mind Control opens up with the Firestorm. Let's see if he gets bullied out of the lane. Yeah, definitely, they might even go for a kill here. There's a lot of blocks by Treants. Rubick will be there to try to help, although the Underlord, no, he does not die, but he's forced to use Solve, and he used almost all of his tangos. And now let's see what's gonna happen in this safe lane for the 5 minutes. impressed by Firestorm a little bit, but both can do ranged attacks. They should slightly be safe there. Mid lane 7-0 opening for Petrider against 5-0 for Puck. Okay, I believe that Petrider should end up being the winner of this mid lane. Top lane, let's take a look. Medusa 8-2. There will be a toss. Venomancer, is he going for the Gale build this time? Most likely not. I expect the Plague Ward build again, like in every game of this tournament, I believe. There's the Solve from the Vengeful Spirit. Let's see. Level 2 Venomancer does take Gale. Okay. Tiny has his avalanche. He will try to recover some mana with the clarity, and then I believe they will be able to go for kills if they catch Vengeful Spirit out of position. They are pulling the creeps a little bit. Miracle already has a Wraith Band, he has Blooded Blade, he's going for another Wraith Band. Puck will be struggling. I mean, he does have. Okay, kill button. Nature's Prophet dies. And let's see what the Troll Warlord do here. He spent all of his regeneration. Expect his support to bring some from base now. He is 12-0, and the Underlord is 10-2. Last hits. Okay. Let's see. There's the Tangos. Nature's Prophet only has one. Okay. This lane will be difficult for the Troll. There will be a lot of harassment from the Firestorm. Underlord has another Mango. There will be a lot of harassment from the Fate Bolt. But they are able to return a little bit of damage. On the side of Nikmat, they will have to use a lot of regen. They ran out of it just now. Minute 4, they want to control the bottom rune. No, it spawns top. There's the DD. Will Puck be able to take it? No, Nature's Prophet takes it. Okay, he will do some damage on the Petrider. Is Petrider running away? No, no, he dies. Puck is there with the assist. There's a cute little tip. Although Tiny denied himself on the tier 2 tower, he wanted to go to base and take the regen, take the boots, and return with the infused raindrop. Now, Miracle has completed 2 Wraith Bands. Is he queuing up Midas? Yes. He might go for the Treads first and then Midas. Venomancer does have one level of Plague Wards. Puck died mid. What happened there? Let's go back a little bit and see. Wow, he was caught out of position. Tried to TP, but no. Okay, let's go live. What's happening here? Are any action top? There's a big pull camp here. Radiant will be able to divert their catapult into it. Bottom lane, Troll 27-2 against Underlord 21-2. Slight advantage there. Let's see if they will be able to do a little bit of damage. Radiant's to the Underlord top tower here. Is under attack. There's the help from the Rubik. Top lane, Revenge died to a combination of Gale and Avalanche and Toss. That's not surprising too much. Let's see. Venomancer is relatively farmed, 22 and 4, although look at Medusa, 33 and 8. Let's see, yeah, he will go for treads there, and then minus. Now, the Venomancer has one level in Gale just for slow, but he will be forcing Plague Wards. What happened bottom? There's the trade. Rubik died, but in exchange, Troll Warlord was killed and Pockdeep ganked to kill the Underlord. I missed that, sorry. Now there was a lot of action. Now let's see. Rubik TPing mid. He wants to bring some items. Okay, do they have enough for the Nasu? No. Puck will be able to get away there. And they want to put some pressure with the catapult on the tier 1 tower.
Radiant's middle tower is under attack.
Now he has
dire
enough mana for the Nasu.
He
can land a good flame break. Okay, Puck is playing dangerously here. Let's see if Rubik wants to hang around and if they want to try to kill this Puck. Bottom lane, no action. There's a good ward behind the tower, mid tier 1 tower, for the side of Nygma.
Radiant's towers are fortified!
Here.
Just
let's
like
see.
That!
They want to go Tiny Mandai here. Nope. Will be able to get away, maybe. No, there's the Batrider. One more. Okay, he died. Good rotation by mid Batrider. Medusa will be forced to go back to base and heal up.
Illusion.
Venomancer, level 6. Does not take the Poison Nova. He has 3 levels in Plague Ward. Mid lane. Bench. We'll go for the D wards, maybe. Let's see. Is he gonna scout this ward? No, he doesn't use his sentry. Bottom lane. Mind control on his underlord, 38 and 3. Troll warlord, 51 and 2. He will be going for drums as his first item. Okay. Faded brooch for Batrider. He should be
Dire's
very
middle
quick
tower
and
is
here.
Under attack.
Yes. His next item will be Boots of Travel. Wow, look at this. 10 minutes Boots of Travel. That's very impressive start for the Batrider. Top lane. Let's see what happens with Puck here. He will get stunned. Yes, there's the snake. A lot of damage done to him. He will run away. Now, the Hand of Midas queued up for Medusa. He is level 6 and a half. Vengeful Spirit might want to get her level 6. Venomancer level 7. And he leveled up Plague Wards completely. So they want a lot of early push, a lot of early vision, and higher damage output. Now, look at what Batrider will be going for Tiny. Because he wants to do as much damage as he can, and he dies. Where is the troll? He is farming happily. He should have drums ready soon. Underlord has completed arcane boots, has the bottle, and he will be going for what? Pipe? Most likely pipe for his next item. Puck has bottled regen, and there's the ult, there's the silence. It's time he's gonna hit the avalanche, toss, let's see. No, Batrider doesn't die, uses flaming lasso, and they turn around. That's 2 kills for Nygma. Pretty nice play there. Very impressive. Tiny was just slightly slow. If he casted his spells a little bit earlier and they had one more right click, the Batrider would have died. A little bit unlucky there. There is the 8-2-4 and 1k net worth lead for the side of Nigma. Venomancer did push the top lane. Nigma loses their safe lane tier 1 tower. Medusa is happing, is farming happily. She has 4 levels in split shot. Okay. Going for Midas next. There it is. 11 minute Midas. Let's see. What does Venom do? Oh, look at that. Very aggressive play from Batrider and Venge. There is the dead Nature's Prophet. What do they want to do? Do they want to push tier 1 tower? There's the ult from Puck, there Toss Avalanche, and that's dead Underlord. Okay. Gale on Batrider, do they want to catch him? Is he gonna lose Pozanova? Yes. Batrider will be forced to run away. Let's see if he goes base or stays here. He is playing a dangerous game. There will be a toss on him. He will tank a lot of damage here. Although they will not be able to kill him. They expended Puck's ult. They expended Venomancer's ult. And Tiny is level 6. He is 3-3 into Avalanche and Toss. Okay, now look at the warding. Like I always say, in Nigma's games, they have some really unusual, very offensive wards. One behind tier 1 tower, one next to the tier 2 tower on the bottom in the jungle. They probably want to see where the troll goes for his farming
Dire's
patterns.
Top tower is under attack.
Batrider going back to base to heal. They do have one defensive ward next to their offlane tier 1 tower. Well, let's see, there's the Venge. There's the Underlord. Do they want? He already has completed his Hood of Defiance, going for Halberd next. Do they want to pressure this
tower?
Probably not
attack.
Just yet. Mid, Rubik steals the Plague Ward. Missed Gale. No, he hit the Gale. There's the Avalanche Toss. Tiny might pay with his life here. Yes, there's the dead Rubik as well. Underlord TPing to the tower. Puck was diving slightly. He will be able to disengage here unless... No, he was forced to use the ult. And is Batrider gonna catch him? No, not able to do it. Although he is pushing, he really wants to see where the Puck goes. He has Flaming Lasso, there's a little bit of taunting there. And they disengage. Venomancer will try to put a lot of pressure mid. Let's see, there's the Flaming Lasso on the bottom on Nature's Prophet. He dies. Okay, solo kill by Batrider. He will be going for a blink next. Okay, what does Tiny have? Not much. He will go for the blink as well, although he will need a lot of time to farm it. Venomancer with his arcane boots, he might want to go for what? Is he going straight for Guardian Greaves or maybe Pipe? I'm not sure. Puck has his blink ready. Troll has completed Yasha, going for Mjolnir next. Let's see if they want to push here. No. Medusa going for Manta. Okay, there's the Rubik, died mid. Puck did dive a little bit, takes a lot of damage. There's the swap. Are they gonna stun him? No, but he dies to mind control.
Okay.
Well, I don't know how happy they are with that trade. Support for a support. Sorry, support for a mid. Yeah, I don't know if that's what they wanted to do here. There it is. Venomancer is on going for Guardian Greaves. Another kill for the combination of Batrider and Venge. Tiny. They want to push more. Let's see if they catch Nature's Prophet. Medusa looks knocking down. There's the Underlord. And that's the dead Nature's Prophet. Puck will be able to disengage. They want more. There's the stun on Necromancer. There's the snake. Is he gonna die? Yes, he used his ult before he died. Claiming that Sue was used. Let's see, there's the stun on Troll. I don't think they will push more on him. There's the Rubik. Does he want to help them? Rubik here. There's the stun. Troll is forced to use his ult and run away. They are still chasing. Are they gonna catch Tiny? Yes, he dies to the stun of Wench. Well, pretty messy fight. Five men end up on the losing side here. 17-7 opening for Enigma. And 5k net worth lead. They took the mid tower. They will probably want to push bottom now. The other two towers are not damaged too much. Their mid tower is extremely healthy. Bottom tower slightly damaged. Now, they have this ward which will expire soon. I think they want to put some wards. Let's see on the Puck. He will be able to use his ult and run away. Yes, a little bit of help from the Venomancer. Let's see, what is next item for Underlord? Is he going for Yules? Not sure. Maybe. Rubik has completed his Etherlands. Bench is going drums next. Medusa has completed her Manta. There's the initiation, and that's the dead Tiny. Okay, on the other side, Batrider has found, he has Blink ready, he found Troll Warlord, he's pinging him, he wants to try something. There's the Flaming Lasso, this might be dead Troll, yes, solo kill. Now, they want more, Nature's Prophet, he is in a lot of trouble here, there's the dead Prophet. Okay, the aggressive plays from Enigma. Tower is not what it used to be. They took the bottom tower with the Medusa and Venge. She will be going for... what? What's this? Talisman? Cute? Going for Skadi next, probably. It will be extremely useful against Troll. Once that is completed. Venomancer doesn't have Guardian Greaves just yet. Bottom, use that first to use ult. There's the Avalanche, there's the Toss. Dead Tiny, can they kill Prophet? Yes, they can. Puck used ult, dies as well. There's the Poison Nova from Venomancer, although he did not hit anything. I don't know, that was a little bit misplayed there. Batrider will chase him, there's a lot of sticky napalm charges, and that's the dead Venomancer. This looks like a very, very difficult game for the side of five men. But now there is the pressure on bottom tier 2, Medusa will claim the tower. And now they have complete control over the bottom side of the map. Let's see.
Dire's middle tower
this
is under
ward,
attack.
Standard Enigma placing their ward. They really like this ward. In a couple of their games they used it. Now what's going to happen? Do they want to smoke? Yes. And they will go for the try. There's the ult from Puck. There's the silence. Though he will probably give his life here. Yes. Venomancer slowing them down with Gale a little bit. There's the Blink Lasso on Troll. He might die here. Medusa using his ult. There's the dead Venomancer. Puck buys back. They will want to chase Tiny here. Is their swamp ready? Yes. In range? No, not yet. Drums used. He will get slowed and killed. There's the dead Tiny. 28 to 8, 13k network pushing top tier 1 tower. Well, extremely bad and difficult game for Flyman. I don't know how are they gonna return after this. Puck dies where? On the right side of the map.
Top tower has
died
fallen.
To
do not blame
Bench Rider. Okay. Now let's see what do they want to do next. Push mid tier 2 maybe. Yeah, there's the Yules for Underlord. Medusa has completed her Heaven's Halberd. She has People's Gift, queuing up Skadi. Then Bench drums only. She will go for more Glimmer Cape after that. This Nature Prophet is extremely poor. He will be hiding, although they are scouting him. He will maybe TP away. Let's see if he can juke in the trees. Nope, Underlord found him. Let's see, he has Yules to cancel his TP. Let's see if he does catch him. Yeah, they do. There's the one stun. Is there a second one? No. No, he runs away actually. Okay. Good play there. Although Troll went in for the Roche. He was ulted by Batrider to swap. He should be dead here. Yes, that is dead Troll. By miracle. Let's see what's happening with Tiny. He doesn't have anything to kill the Rubik and dead Tiny, dead Venomancer. I think that 5 men are probably ready to pull GG's here. Puck gets caught. No, he runs away. Batrider wants to chase him. Puck forced to use ult. Let's see. Rubik lifts him. And there's the dead Puck. Complete stomp by Enigma. I think they will be able to close out the game very quickly. And yeah, there he is. GG's called. No hope. No hope for the side of 5 men. They did take one game from Enigma, but they got completely destroyed in game 3. And that's it. 2-1 series for the side of Enigma.